So this is my Samsung USB charger, which suddenly died. I've got this one for about 2 years and I almost never use it because I have a lot of other USB chargers. And I mostly charge my phone from my computer, so this one has seen very little use. Then I took it on holiday and it stopped working, and this is the worst situation when this can happen. It seems like a real Samsung, but it failed after so little use. That's weird. When I plug it in, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. It blinks a little bit. When I smell it, I can smell an electrolyte. Sometimes you can guess the fault just by smelling it. Because an electrolytic capacitor has a typical smell of electrolyte, and resistors also have a typical smell when burning, and semiconductors or transistors or chips have a typical smell, and a winding of a transformer or an inductor has a typical smell, and also a burning board has a typical smell. So sometimes you can tell the fault just by smelling it. In this one I can smell an electrolyte leaking out of an electrolytic capacitor. It's a shame this one failed because it really doesn't look fake to me. But now let's take a look inside. How do I open it up? Probably from this side. So let's try to pry this one open. This is going to be complicated and maybe bloody. This is really not easy to open. And that's it. And this is the board. With some capacitors, inductor, transistor, transformer. This is probably the secondary capacitor. There are some SMD components, some control chip, bridge rectifier here probably. And this is probably the secondary diode, usually a Schottky diode. This one seems to be a fusible resistor. It's a fuse and an inrush resistor in one package. And this one seems to be the interference inductor. The separation seems to be very good. From here to here. And there is a spark gap, isn't it? That's interesting. The distance is about 5 millimeters. Unlike in the Chinese ones where it is like half a millimeter. This is the control chip, if anybody is interested. It seems to be quite well made. It's from 2014. But there must be some capacitor failing. There are two primary capacitors, 6.8 micro, 400 volts, and a secondary capacitor, 470 microfarads, 7.5 volts. That's quite a strange value. So I've put another capacitor instead of this small one, and no, it still doesn't work properly. It blinks. So let's try to replace one of the other capacitors. And it still doesn't work. I was trying to replace this Schottky diode and also this small auxiliary diode, and still nothing. I'm testing it using a 40 watt light bulb in series just for the case it goes short circuit. I have drawn a schematic of it and it looks more or less typical. There is an inrush resistor with fusible function. There is a bridge rectifier, first capacitor, interference filter, another capacitor. There is a primary winding with a snubber network, a switching transistor, auxiliary winding. There is a diode and capacitor rectifying it and generating power for the chip. There are some startup resistors, quite high values, 22 megaohms each, so in total it's 44 megaohms. Crazy high value. For no apparent reason there is another 22 megaohm resistor going to the negative. And there is the primary with a diode, it's a Schottky diode, and a capacitor as usually. There is also a snubber network, it's okay, and then there is this circuitry. I have absolutely no explanation for this. This mysterious circuitry has a 3-pin chip in it and two 22 ohm resistors. That's weird. I was thinking it's a synchronous rectifier, but it can't be because it has those resistors in series. So what this is? Maybe some intelligent minimum load, but why it's connected here? Weird. There is another oddity. The emitter of the transistor doesn't go to negative, it goes only into the chip. And there is something that looks like a current sensing resistor. It's a very low value, just 1.1 ohms. But it's not connected from here to here. It must be connected just internally in the chip. That's strange. Startup resistors usually go into the base of the transistor if there is no control chip. And if there is one, they usually go only into the chip. But in this case, it goes into both the chip and the transistor. Maybe this is why the emitter is not connected to the negative. Because otherwise, this junction with a very low resistance would pull this voltage down. I was trying to replace this one, this one, this one, and this one. And it still doesn't work. The voltage of this capacitor is jumping up and down from about 7 to about 9 volts. So now, the power supply finally works. Finally, the problem was the electrolyte, the liquid from this capacitor spilling into this startup circuitry and shunting it. Because the current through those super high resistors is so tiny, it's so easy to shunt it. After cleaning the board, it works normally. And it shows up that those electrolytic capacitors are quite tricky. Not only the failure of this capacitor itself can cause problems, but also the liquid spilling from it. Sometimes just replacing the capacitor is not enough and you have to carefully clean the board. 9999 subscribers! That's crazy! So that's my power supply working again. This is Diagon Wild and see you in my next videos.